Hi everyone, my name is Paul Brosesen, and today I'm going to show you how to use and install the Go Z bridge between Houdini and Zbrush. Alright, so to get started, the first thing we need to do is simply open Zbrush. In this case, I'm going to open Zbrush 2021, but you can use a different version of Zbrush as well. Once ZBrush is open, we just click the lightbox, and in this case, I'm just going to click any of the demo projects. You don't have to, you can use your own projects as well, but for demonstrational purposes, I'm just going to open this one. All right, so the first time you do this, you need to click on the Go Z button, just like you would with any other DCC, which will open up this prompt here, where it says several versions of Houdini have been detected. And that will present you with this long list of Houdini versions. So which one do you pick? I would just suggest you pick the version that you're going to be using, for example, 18.5.401. You don't need to change this every single time you update a daily build of Houdini. I recommend you just do this whenever you update between major versions of Houdini. So for example, Houdini 18.0 or 18.5. Since I'm using 401, this is the version that I'm going to select. Once we click that button, we will see that ZBrush is just processing, and then we'll be exporting this to Houdini. This takes a little longer the first time since it's configuring things, but afterwards it is really fast. So now that we click the Go Z button, we of course need to import it into Houdini. And the way we do that is by just simply typing Go Z inside of the geometry context and drop down the Go Z import node. Set the display flag and click the reload button, and we will see that we now have the geometry imported from ZBrush. But as you might notice, there are two things that aren't completely the way that we want. And the first one being the resolution of the geometry. This was not the resolution that we had inside of ZBrush. And the reason for that is that the GoZ functionality in ZBrush automatically exports the lowest subdivision level found on the subtool. So if we scroll down here on the right side, we just look for the geometry section and just slide up the slider all the way to the top so that we have the higher resolution version that we had before. And then we just click delete lower because it, once again, it will always export the lowest subdivision level. Once you do that, we can go back up to the top part. And instead of clicking the Go Z button, we can also click the all button. And this will export all of the subtools that we have in our scene here as separate objects inside of Houdini. So let's go back to Houdini, find the GoZ import node. In this case, since I like to keep a copy of the older version, I'm just going to create another GoZ import node, set the display flag on this one, and click reload. And since we click the all button, we can now see that we have this version with all of these subtools exported. And then here on the node on the left, we have the one where we exported the lower one. So by simply creating a new GoZ import node, we can import, you know, different GoZ exports separately. So let's try exporting the other way from Houdini to ZBrush. And the way we do that is by simply dropping down a GoZ export node instead of an import node, wire in our geometry and click the send to ZBrush. And once we do that, we will see that we have our geometry here. So how do you export separate subtools? Well, let's add in a rubber toy into our scene. And I'm just going to wire that together with the rubber toy like that, so that now we have the geometry of the pig head and the geometry of the rubber toy. If we export this, you might expect it to be separate subtools, but that is not the case. The reason for that is that Houdini will be looking for a name attribute on geometry to split them into subtools. So that is fairly easy to add. All we really just need to do is add a name sub, and just here in the name tab, we're just going to call this one rubber toy, and we're going to call this one pig head. Once we have that, we click send to ZBrush again. And as we can see now, we have a separate rubber toy and a separate pig head.